at Fairplex in Pomona, California. I'm Mark Shays with Arlo Eisenberg. Two big titles on the line. The guy who wins this contest is world champion, and of course, the guy who earns the most points throughout the season becomes the number one ranked and tour champion. 10 guys have qualified, all of them unbelievable skaters, but some big surprises.
Yeah, there were some big surprises. Let's talk about something that wasn't such a big surprise first. The number two ranked rider in the world is Brian Aragon. He's qualified for this finals event in second place. No big surprise there. But the number one ranked rider in the world, Stefan Alfano, failed to make the cut. He's not going to be in this finals field, so that is a big deal. This event, remember, is worth twice the points of any normal ASA Pro Tour stop, so he's conceding a lot of points. Now, who is in this field? We've got three world champions, Sven Bokers, Jaron Grobe, and the defending Pro Tour and world champion, Blake Dennis. And we've also got some new faces. Jeff Stockwell qualified first for this finals.
Yeah, there are four of the top five ranked skaters in the world now battling for that number one ranking, but it's wide open with Jeff Stockwell in the lead. He's with Davey right now.
Thanks. I'm here with Jeff Stockwell. First place going in the finals. First contest. The biggest contest of the year. What do you feel? How do you feel right now?
Well, I'm just feeling like, you know, trying to have a good time, skate, you know, land on my tricks, just have a good time.
Nice. You do some unique tricks like the hand plant over the box, the little shuffles no one else is doing. Does that set you apart from these guys? Is that what put you in first?
I guess, but I don't know. I just had two really good runs that I landed good, and I guess that just put me in first. I was really surprised.
Nice. Good luck.
Thank you.
Have fun. Thanks.
All right, you too.
Mr. Stockwell poised to try to take his first ever world championship title. Unseasonably cold weather out here at Fairplex in Pomona. A solid field of competitors narrowed down from 32 to our final 10. No surprise that Brian Aragon is in the finals. Eric Bailey as well. Sven Bokers, out with injury, is back. Once again, hoping to take another world championship title.
Carl Hills has been having a breakout season, and the monster is always a threat in any finals field. Blake O'Brien's a rising star, and Louis Zamora has been there before. And a new face, Clark Kirkman. And of course, the reigning champion, Blake Dennis, rounds out the field.
It's time for Inline Street Finals. 10 guys, 2 runs, 100 point scale, 65 seconds on the clock. Best run wins!
Well, surprises, Blake Dennis has qualified for this finals in 10th position. Barely eking his way in, that means he's got the added pressure of having to skate first.
As good as Blake is, he can strike from any position.
Blake Dennis is tight. He puts a run together, it just flows so perfect.
He looks at a course differently than every single other pro out there. He looks for tricks for himself, you know, tricks that he wants to do, and the lines that he wants to link together. And with the songs he chooses to put in his runs, it just puts the whole package together. And it gives an overall feeling of how good he is as a skater.
Smoothest style, smoothest tricks. Like, he'll do the tricks that no one else ever think of and no one else will ever do, you know?
It's more of an art form for him, I guess.
It makes it look so nice.
Well, he's already made his mark in rollerblading. He's another Australian who's been at the top of the sport, and he's starting at the most difficult part of the course.
Yes, attacking that kink rail, going backside all the way through the kink and right into the 540, into the transition. An exciting start for Blake Dennis. This is the kind of run he's got to have, backside, half slide, balanced all the way around that corner box. This is a great start for Blake Dennis, the world champion, trying to defend his title.
What a great way to start. That rail, the big rail at the top, that is truly a rollerblading rail.
Going wall ride to backside rail, creative move, and then going down on that little wall stall on the pigeon post.
That is not something you normally see from Blake Dennis.
Wow, that is a huge, huge break. He's trying to defend his title. He has it all going. And then there on that kind of that throwaway trick to go down. What a tough break for Blake Dennis.
A lot of poise, though. Look at him getting back up immediately, and he hasn't missed a trick since.
Well, listen, this is the finals. That means he's got two chances to put it together. He can throw out this run, but this is his chance to try and put it together, to work out his line. Even with the fall, he gets a shot to work on some of these tricks like that. Farside sole to Soy Hal transfer. That is a big move. And Blake showed that he has a lot of big moves in this run. If he can land them all in the second round, he's got a great shot at repeating as champion. That balanced fast slide is going to get a lot of respect from the street skaters. It's a difficult move. And then look at this topside sole transfer to Soy Hal. He doesn't ride away from it, but he did the hard part. That's got to have the other skaters worried about their runs.
Well, he sets the bar pretty high, 88.25. Now all he can do is wait for the other riders to take their runs. You can't mess up, not with guys like Brian Aragon and Jaron Grove still to skate. The LG Action Sports Championships is brought to you by LG Mobile Phones. Expression completed. By Yoohoo. Yoohoo's first run with an 88.25 sitting next to another former world champion, Mr. Jaron Grove, who will take his drop. Some amazing skaters who made it into the finals. But of the 32 riders in the prelims, the big surprise, Stefan Alfano not making the cut.
Stefan is ranked number one in the world coming into the finals, but he had a tough time in the prelims. And it's a testament to how competitive this street field is. The number one ranked rider in the world did not make the final.
Just missing in 12th place, Randy Spicer, another former world champion out of Cypress, California, always good for some very exciting moves, but did not make the cut of 10.
Anytime you get a top contest like this, all the best skaters are going to come out, and you always end up with competitive fields that go very deep. And it's just the inescapable reality that sometimes top riders are not going to make it into the finals. Like Brian Shima, the most celebrated street skater in the world, but not even Shima could skate his way into the finals.
With an average of 2 runs, the prelims really looks at consistency. Brian Shima definitely lit up the course with some huge moves, but missed a couple tricks and paid the price.
Hardcore.
When you put up the big prize money, you never know who's going to come out of the woodwork. After a brief hiatus, the Burgeonator is back and up to his old exciting ways, but failed to make the finals, but never fails to excite.
Out of Boise, Idaho, Mr. Eric Bailey's been on the tour now for a couple of years, and he put together some incredibly consistent runs in the prelims, so he'll have 2 more shots in the finals to try to take home the big money.
Hardcore Brazil, Carlos Pianowski, definitely one of the fan favorites coming into the event. Definitely didn't shy away from the big tricks, but in the prelims you have to have 2 solid runs, and Carlos failed to make the cut. Someone who did not fail to make the cut is former world champion Sven Boker, who qualified in good position.
Sven, obviously you've been training since you came back.
Yeah, the last month I skated a lot with friends at home, you know.
It's dangerous. Even talking to the camera's dangerous out here in rollerblading.
Yeah, I guess so.
What a season this guy has had, and what a career. Sven Boker's in 2000 was absolutely unbeatable. Took some time off in 2001. 2002 had some injury. This year had some injury. Came back for the X Games Global Championship and won it on the street course. And then came out here and put together some amazing runs in the prelims. Good enough to get an average score of 86.63.
All eyes will be on this young man, Brian Aragon, the number 2 ranked rider in the world and the most dominant competitor this season on the Pro Tour. He's won 3 out of the 4 Pro Tour stops, and he's got to feel like this number 1 ranking is rightfully his.
Have you been drinking?
Come on, are you kidding me?
If anyone hopes to roll away with the world championship in 2003, they're going to have to take it away from this man. The reigning world champ, Blake Dennis, has made it into the finals to defend his title. And after his first run performance, he is not laying down for anyone. But the advantage of the number 1 seed going into the finals is this young man, Jeff Stockwell, a relative unknown on the Pro Tour, but no stranger to fans of street rollerblading. One of the top young street skaters in the world, Jeff had technical skill and great lines to qualify number 1 coming out of prelims.
So in the finals, Blake Dennis has laid down an 88.25, but he left room for improvement. Clark Kirkman is the only rookie to have made his way into the top 10, but he has already become a veteran of competition.
When I was on the amateur circuit, it always seemed like there was a lot of pressure to do good and, you know, so I could turn pro eventually. And now, this whole year, the pressure is basically off because I'm just skating with a bunch of my friends that I already knew from years and years of skating. So it's really just enjoyment now. Like, I'm entertained the whole time that I skate here.
Wow, and talk about being entertained. That's entertainment for you. A 360 disaster soul up on the corner pole and now going backside royale around that small corner ledge. That was an amazing start to the run, Mark. One of the best tricks we've seen this entire weekend.
Now you'll notice something. He's got a very, very tall stature out here on the course, and it affects the way he looks when he does tricks. not afraid to try big, big spins there with a 900 over the launch box.
No, and look at the way he compresses out the tricks. It's so cool. When you can have good style like that, being so tall, it really says something about your skill. And you'll notice something else, Mark, about the way that Clark is missing some of these tricks. He's actually staying on his feet, so it's not going to hurt his line too much, although they will count him down on consistency a little bit.
Looks like he's completely winded. He started off with such a bang, now trying to finish up with something good. Looked like he was going for a topside acid, just couldn't get his leg up underneath.
Well, and let's not discount how hard that last trick he was trying was. That ledge is deceptively tall. I mean, that probably comes up to Clark's nipples. Look at it right here. That is a tall, tall ledge. So that's hard to jump onto at the end of a run.
And it's not every day you get to hear the word nipple in a skating show.
Can we say that on TV?
Of course you can say it. Check it out. 360 topside soul grind up into the bowl. And then here, throwing a little misty flip, getting upside down, a little old school 540 inverted, and then the 900 compressing on the landing. 82.75 puts him currently in second position.
Louis Zamora has been an icon in the sport of rollerblading for longer than anyone. Everything he does looks really, really good. He's just one of the rollerblading icons that you look up to.
Louis truly is a living legend, one of the fixtures of the influential Southern California street skating scene. No one has better style than Louis Zamora, one of the greatest ambassadors for the sport. His style is so fast and so fluid. Every trick he does, he charges at and executes with such beautiful fluidity. And Louis Zamora's been busy behind the scenes, started several companies now. And he finds himself in the finals of the World Championships. Louis Zamora has been one of the few street skaters who has really excelled at translating his pure street skills into park contests.
Louis dropping in with lots of speed, known as a street skater, making finals in most of the contests he goes to when you actually do see him. She's going to the ledge, topside acid and fake into the bank.
Louis starting off strong, having a little trouble there in the bowl. Some creativity on the course, which you'd expect from him, but then missing right there. Falling down, that would hurt his score. Only an 80.25 currently puts him in third place, with many skaters still to come. When we come back, it's an X Games gold medalist and world champion hoping to take home ASA gold.
12.
Welcome back to the LG Action Sport Championships and the ASA Street World Championships. Up next, a guy who has helped define rollerblading and a go-big attitude. It's Mr. Jaron the Monster Grove.
Jaron is crazy.
He has no fear.
He doesn't have any fear about anything that he does in his runs, and he looks for the biggest and the gnarliest tricks to do.
He's nicknamed the Monster, so it's... It's like that. He's just crazy. You don't expect him to. He'll drop in and he'll just throw like a 900 or a backflip for wall ride or something. He's telling me he wanted to try that. So you never know what he's gonna do.
That balls to the walls attitude and go for broke style has earned Jaron the number one ranking in the world, two X Games titles, and the title of world champion. And he would sure like to see that happen one more time here.
Of course, that go for broke mentality is a double-edged sword. You live by the sword, you die by the sword. And sometimes when you take those big risks, it can come back to bite you in the behind. Jaron Grove starting out fast here as he goes backside across the quarter pipe. Now setting up, running up the wall, getting a lot of speed as he heads for a hitching post. Big 360 all the way over the hitching post and going down.
Unfortunate, it's like he looped out there. It looked like he didn't get quite the height he wanted up and over the hitching post. Looked like he was thinking about planting his foot on top and didn't.
Well, you can see the way that Jaron looked at this course, throwing the 900, which we haven't seen a lot this year from Jaron. And in fact, that wasn't his signature 900. It was slightly a different rotation, a more conventional 900 from Jaron. Backside Royale down the handrail. And he's got to know after that fall that this is probably not going to be the run that wins him the championship. He's going to have to wait for a second run. But he's still got time, so he's going to work on his line a little bit. You can see he's lost some energy.
Oh, going down on an alley-oop fish brain, Jaron Grove looked like he slid out on the coping. The metal out here is definitely more slick than these guys are used to because of the cold weather.
Well, look at this 900. It's great execution, but the 900 we're used to seeing from Jaron is more wild. It always used to look out of control, and it was so exciting. And as you mentioned, the coping definitely looks slick on that alley-oop fish frame.
Well, Jaron's been in this position before. He's going to have to put it all on the line in run number two if he wants to take home the world championship title.
Halfway through the first runs, Blake Dennis, even with a less than perfect run, still showed enough to be in number one, but we've still got the top five seeded riders left to skate.
The Jaron Grove that we all know and love did not come out for the first run of competition. He is not within striking distance. However, the Monster is the proud owner of an LG VX6000 picture phone, and he wanted to share some of his life with everybody. This is his Dialed In. On the street course here at the LG Action Sports Championships, Blake Dennis is the current leader, but he's got a long road ahead of him. An 88.25 will probably not be the mark to beat. Carl Hills has actually become a bona fide contender this season, coming on strong, and by the end of the regular season, pulling the first ever 1260 in a competition run.
This really was a breakout year for Carl Hills. Originally qualified on the Pro Tour as a vert skater, started skating in the street contest, and this season really made a name for himself. And now he finds himself in the World Championship Finals, starting out with the 900. No problem for the kid who's landed the 1260, 360 into the wall ride, and now trying to switch it up on the coping, but falling down. And look at the hustles. He gets back up. He knows he's got a lot of time left in the run, and he sees that Blake Dennis is on top with the fall in his run. So you cannot scratch these runs right now. There's too much at stake.
Well, and that's got to be frustrating because, again, this coping is very slick.
Well, it's night and it's cold, so there's condensation on the coping. It's getting slick for these guys, and it is posing some problems, but it's the same disadvantage for every rider. They've got to contend with it.
Carl Hills trying to bring home some bacon for his lady. He's got a new child. Oh, again, the same trick that Jaron Grove had trouble with, and he's saying, yup, the coping is super, super slick.
Carl's very first trick was a 900, and you'll notice we're seeing a lot of 900s here in this World Championship. Carl's got to be thinking that he can throw his 1260 in the second run and really distinguish himself from the crowd.
What happened, Carl? You slipped up the same place Jaron is, the water factor?
Yeah, it's not so bad on the ramps or the ground, but it gets on the coping and then the wax. This makes it twice as fast. You can't even hold a grind at all.
You hit the 900, then back-to-back 540. Was that feel good?
Yeah, I was feeling real good, but the coping screwed me up. So let's have to see what happens.
1260?
It's going to happen. Next year.
You heard it first. Good luck.
Up next, Sven Bokhorst out of Den Bosch, Holland. This guy has had quite an illustrious park career. In 2000, he was virtually unbeatable, winning almost every regular season stop, the Gravity Games, the X Games, the World Championships, and locking down the number one ranking in the world. And his talents have not subsided. He's just taken some time away from the competition circuit, but when he comes back, he's always on.
Starting out with an interesting line, now he heads straight for the launch box, a chance to earn some big amplitude points as he goes upside down with the flat spin 360 right into the 540 wall ride.
You can bet he's going to be careful. Up there on the pommel horse, check it out. It looked like it was a little bit slippery, Hopefully he was taking notes after watching a couple guys go down on the coping.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments these guys make and what precaution they take to guard against this slick coping. Sven Bokers now up on top of the quarter pipe, setting up for something.
Very brave, going right there, locking on Soul, and then taking a different line through the spine.
Actually, it was a great line. He went Soul in the sub box and transferred into the far side of the spine. Great way to get around the court. Right into the true spin, alley-oop topside Soul. And this really is Sven's signature. He keeps moving, gets a lot of tricks into every run.
Really prides himself on trying to be as consistent as possible.
I have to say, there have been a couple of slow points in the line, though, where he's just stopped up on top of decks, finishing off with that disaster soul and falling right at the end. You never like to see a fall, but if it has to happen, may as well be at the very end of the run where it can't hurt your line. Let's look at how he's mixed up these tricks. 540 into the wall ride, and then also the big disaster soul in that high ledge box, which he wasn't able to roll away from, but a great attempt.
Yeah, I fell with the landing. I didn't miss a soul, so I think it's not because of the rain.
Second run. Good luck.
Well, good luck is what is in order for some of these guys. They haven't had perfect runs. Hopefully, Jeff Stockwell will. He and Brian Aragon hoping to take gold away from last year's world champion, Blake Dennis.
I mean, I don't really go out too much at night. My days usually consist of skating, so I usually go to sleep around 1 or 2 in the morning, wake up 11 or 12 the next day, get up, go skate, hang out with friends. Usually every day consists of about 4 or 5 hours of skating. I've grew up my whole life in Brighton, Colorado. It was kind of cool, I think. It's kind of a small town, and 20 minutes away is a big city, so you kind of get 2-in-1. I never skate in Brighton because there's not too much to skate. We always meet up in downtown Denver. We roll around in the park a little bit, go skate streets. No, I'm not a big fan of the snow. Hopefully I'll be getting to California this winter to escape it. Coming from a small town to being a pro rollerblader has changed my life a lot. I've been able to travel a lot more. I've met people I would never have met before. People like Randy Spicer, John Julio, Louis Zamora. I grew up my whole life looking at them and being like, wow, how amazing would it be to skate with them, and now I'm friends with them and travel with them. It's cool to beat them too sometimes. I think it's a sport because every day I get up and I work hard and I'm training my body to be the best it can be. But it's also an art because everyone puts their own style into it. You do what you want to do. And I'm doing what I love to do, and I'm getting paid for it and traveling. And I'm skating every day, so I couldn't ask for much more right now.
Well, the one thing he could ask for is the world championship title, and now is his chance.
He's done everything he needed to put himself in position. This is what it comes down to for Brian Aragon in his stellar season. 540 up onto the deck, and if he's going to skate away with this title, he's got to outclass everyone on the coping. Here he goes, set up for one of his big grind moves. 270 into the backside Farfignugan, backside Royale.
And if he takes the same run or a similar line to what he did in the prelim round, it's a gutsy move because he does do so many lip tricks.
Well, all through the prelims, he was landing that hurricane farside soul on the disaster ledge, and that is a trick he needs to land here in the finals if he wants to have a shot at this title. Setting up, heading for the ledge now. This may be it. Spinning blind, 360, topside soul, and he sticks it. Perfect execution. That's exactly the trick he needed. This bodes very well for Brian Aragon, trying to earn that number one ranking.
Well, you'll hear so many of his peers say that that is a best trick, the kind of trick that you do in best trick contests because of a lack of consistency. Check it out.
What a great transfer, and what a great run that Brian Aragon is having. And there is no underestimating that trick. That blind 360 to soul that he did, just as you mentioned, the kind of trick guys hope to land in a best trick contest. The fact that Brian lands it every time in his run is just unbelievable.
Well, he's got to be pumped with the way he finished his run as well. Check it out. That is incredibly difficult, and he lands it every time, and then finishing off with a 630-degree transfer.
Brian Aragon, that run was amazing. The best run of the day. You're in first place right now. How do you feel? What are you thinking right now?
I mean, I feel good. I finally got all my tricks down that run. Hit everything smooth. I hit my hurricane topsail. I'm just juiced. In the last 8 seconds, I had extra time, so I went and did the 650 into that quarter pipe, so I'm juiced.
Did you even practice that this weekend?
No, I didn't practice it. I looked at it, and it was one of those tricks where I knew if I would just have to do if I did it.
So you're in the second one.
Just to be clear, that trick that Brian called a 650, we actually break down the spins in increments of 90 degrees. So it is a 630, but when you're throwing it and landing it like Brian does, you can call it whatever you want.
And that trick, of course, good enough to put him in the top spot. But Jeff Stockwell was ahead of all of the skaters coming out of the prelims. Would love to put himself back on top so everybody can play catch-up in round number two.
Well, and he's had a golden opportunity here. Really, the only great run we've seen in the first round was just put down by Brian Aragon. Starting out with that creative hip-hop cess slide over the launch box. Very creative use of the launch box. Most guys spinning over it, of course. Jeff Stockwell of San Clemente, California, is one of the top street skaters in the world, showing it right there with the true Mizu down that disaster ledge box. And look at this, alley backside unity.
And the reason, a good reason, why the judges are so impressed is he's bringing some creativity, some new tricks, but he's also really defining every single grind.
Absolutely. If you're going to be creative, that's cool, but you've also got to show that you've really got the skill. You got to learn to walk before you can run, so to speak, and you got to show that you've got the conventional skills as well. Again, going hip-hop over the sub-box, a very dangerous move.
Yeah, a lot of margin for error. You can leave your feet behind, get them hung up, but check out how he's just nailing trick after trick.
Well, you can tell he's put in work on these tricks. You can see in the backside of his jeans he's taken some falls, so you know he's paid his dues. But looking back at the clock, what is he doing? He's still got time left.
Yeah, this is the difference between Brian Aragon, someone who's got so much competition experience this year. He still had time, and yet he didn't take advantage of it. Brian found out he had 8 seconds left and went in through that 6:30 transfer, and Mr. Stockwell just let the time go away.
And it's really too bad, because Jeff had a great run going, landing all those difficult lip tricks at the beginning, showing off his creative moves, the big one over the sub box. But it looks like he only played out 50 seconds of a 65-second run.
Still good enough for second place right now with an 88.75. One run down, and Mr. Aragon is on top, looking for that first ever world championship title here at Fairplex in Pomona, California.
Well, Fairplex in Pomona is known for conventions, meetings, sporting events. We have over 300 events annually, but the largest of which is the LA County Fair. Each year we bring about 1.3 million people to the fair, and overall at Fairplex, with all of our events combined, we have about 3 million visitors each year. It's very much a community venue with families, and there's something for everyone here.
Let's sing a song. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Daddy, would you like to stop this? Down to this, the final run here in the ASA Pro Tour World Championships on the street course. Blake Dennis right now in the bronze medal position, but he sure would like to take home the gold.
Starting out again with that same great line, backside all the way down the handrail into the 540 transfer into the quarter pipe, coming up balancing on the backside fast slide all the way around that bold corner. Remember, Blake hit all these tricks in the first run, and then he went down uncharacteristically on that hitch and post, that little wall stall. So let's see if he can hit it all here in the second run. Oh, he switched it up to a true spin, Soyal. Good move from Blake Dennis, and that's no problem this time around. Much better, already looking to improve this run.
Blake Dennis is rewarded not only for difficulty, but also for creative lines, consistency. He is the complete competition package out here.
And consistency was the only mark against him in the first round. He's cleaned that up here, and he's even raised the bar on the difficulty. This was his most difficult trick in the first round, transferring Soyal, and he rolled away from it. This is the run that Blake Dennis needed to have to defend his title, and he's done it.
And see what happens when you stay on your feet. You have time for one more trick.
Wow, perfect run for Blake Dennis. Coming through like a true champion when he had to.
And this is what you see in the second round of competition. Guys know This is the last chance. Taking a look at the first run and the second run, it all went bad right there the first time around, but the second run, just nailing it.
And again, with the transfer in the first round, he didn't land it. In the second round, able to roll away from it.
Like, Dennis, I hate to break the news to you, but you just took the lead with that run. What's going through your head right now?
I'm just happy to land my run, because in the first I messed up on that stupid little thing, so all day I haven't landed a clean run, and finally, stoked.
Question everyone's asking is, how do you keep landing that back chest side slide around the ball?
Man, I don't even know. That's one trick that when I landed, I surprised myself. Like, I think I got it, then the next time I'll just go down on it, so I don't know. It feels good, though.
Well, you're in first place at 15 Gs right now.
Lake Dennis is possibly facing a second world championship title in a row. Earlier in the day, the women competed in the finals of their world championship. Fallon Heffernan may come in a small package, but she did not shy away from the biggest rails out on the course. Hitting everything, going for some big spins there with a nice 540, a 60.75 gave her the bronze medal.
Martina Svobodova is widely regarded as the best pure street skater in the female class. She lived up to her billing, showing some difficult technical moves, and even the disaster soul rolled away with first place for the females.
73.75, a solid score for her. Fabiola Da Silva came out with high hopes. They were dashed during the first run. Every time she tried to jump on the rail, she had problems. But in the second run, coming back with some very difficult lip tricks, some nice technical grinds, and some consistency, good enough to earn her second place in the Women's World Championship. Congratulations to all the riders, but Martina Svobodova bringing home another big trophy to Slovakia. The 20-year-old, so dominant, she finished the season number one ranked. Now when we come back, it is time for the Monsters' last stand. It's a continuation of run number two.
12 kids? That's nuts.
Wiz Blake Dennis sits on top of the 96.25 here at the LG Action Sports Championships and ASA Pro Tour Street Finals. Here is a look at some of the other skaters who could not best that score here in round number two. Clark Kirkman, the rookie, has got to be very happy with his first ever Pro World Championship finish, but he couldn't get it done.
Yes, a respectable showing for the rookie Clark Kirkman, but he'll have to live with his first round score, and the best he can do is fifth. Luis Zamora knew he'd have to post a whopper of a score in order to contend in the second round. Came out with his signature street style, but had some difficulty. He was not able to improve.
Luis Zamora would have to live with his first run score as well. Everybody trying to put it on the line. Lake O'Brien out of Minneapolis, Minnesota, had a miserable first run. Came out guns a-blazing the second time around. Did some very signature Blake O'Brien moves. Put together some tricks like this transfer, a little backside into the Royale transfer. Definitely a big improvement, but not enough to crack the top five.
The monster, Jaron Grove, knew he had his work cut out for him in the second round. He wanted to regain the championship title. But the way that the monster skates, either you're going to get an impressive run or a huge, disastrous fall. And that's what happened, much to Jaron's disappointment. But everyone was surprised and amazed to see the monster get back up and show his championship heart and finish his run.
Carl Hills called the 1260 after his first run. Came out guns a-blazing, but could not get his feet back down underneath him. Remember, that trick has only been landed once ever in a competition run. So the stakes were high, and he paid the price. Carl putting it together on the coping, having a lot of trouble in the air.
Former world champion Sven Bokers was well in contention after the first run. Looked like he had the line and the moves to skate away with the title. Had the tricks working in the second round, but when all was said and done, it just didn't add up to be enough to beat his first round score. So although he posted a respectable score in the second round, he'd have to live with his first run score and did not move up.
By the time Eric Bailey would get the drop, he'd moved all the way down into the 10th position, but started off with a huge sweat stance down the big rollerblade rail, put together a lot of amazing tricks and moved his way up into the 4th position. So with only two skaters, Brian Aragon and Jeff Stockwell, still to skate, this is how it looks. Brian Aragon and Mr. Stockwell, the only two skaters who can take it away from Blake Dennis, who hopes to be the next champion here at the LG Action Sports Championships, the year-end championships for freestyle motocross, skateboarding, BMX riding, and inline skating. Check out LGActionSports.com for all the airtimes of all of the events. When we come back, we're down to our final two, Brian Aragon and Jeff Stockwell. Go head-to-head. T-Mobile phones, expression completed. By Paul Mitchell. Paul Mitchell's all about style, your style. By Timex, proud sponsor of the LG Action Sports Championships. Life is ticking. And by ASA Events, the leader in action sports event and television production since 1994. Back at the LG Action Sports Championships and the ASA Pro Tour World Championships on street. Some amazing moments, but it didn't always go as planned. Some huge sacrifices made out here, but no one paid the price bigger than Ben Weiss, throwing his life and limbs on the line with Yoo-Hoo's best wrecks. Always an incredibly exciting skater, Ben Weiss unfortunately getting this week's Yoo-Hoo's best wrecks. So Brian Aragon, looking at a possible world championship title, definitely in the running for that number one world ranking right now. Starting off with a big 900.
And Blake Dennis can only watch as Brian Aragon tries to take away this world championship title from Blake Dennis. And here he comes, 720 up onto the deck, already an improvement from the first round. That was a 540 first time out. Here he comes, headed for the rail. 270 topside, sold a hurricane. Brian Aragon is raising the stakes here in the second round.
Such a good run here for Brian Aragon. Now, this has not been the first time that this has happened, where a rookie of the year 1 year becomes world champion the next year. It happened with Jaren Grove. It's happened with Aaron Feinberg. It's happened with a lot of skaters over the course of the history on the ASA Pro Tour. Brian Aragon just hoping to be the next.
Oh no, disaster for Brian Aragon. The one trick he's been hitting so consistently all weekend long, and he misses it here in the second run.
And really all season long, the one trick that's become his trademark because he always nails it.
Yeah, this is the hurricane. It's a blind 360 to topside sole. And what an unfortunate turn of events for Brian Aragon. In this run where he's done everything he could, the 720 up onto the deck, 270 topside sole. I mean, he has brought out the biggest tricks and saved them all for the second run. And then the one trick that we've been seeing all season long, he misses.
Fresh off your run. That was an amazing run until the end. What happened?
Well, I just slipped up on my big trick of my run, the 360 topsail, and it cost me the win. I'm in second right now. I'm pretty disappointed, but what can you do?
Well, Blake Dennis has only one more run to wait through. Jeff Stockwell currently sits in third, but he showed championship form in the prelim round by qualifying first, so he had the honor of skating last, putting the pressure on everybody else first.
Well, and also remember, in his first run, he had all his tricks. He had a great first run. He just didn't finish the full 65 seconds.
Yeah, if he knows what to do with the last 15 seconds of this run, he could be looking at a world championship title.
Absolutely. Setting up Fakey. 270, oh. Disaster, Alif Unity, Seth slide, but not able to land it clean. And every little point here counts. True mistrial. Down the ledge, he's switching up the tricks, which is what you want to do in the second run.
But you also want to stick with what worked for you the first time around. Kind of a little shifty there, getting ready. This part of his run, I think, is the weakest part. He just wastes a lot of time
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. And also you can
see... Oh, trying to 180 to hip-hop out.
I was just going to say that his feet look unsteady on a lot of these landings. Just rolling around, he doesn't seem to be skating with a lot of confidence. And you can see right there, just caught up with him. Maybe he's feeling the pressure. As we've said, he's relative unknown on the competition circuit. Doesn't come out to many contests. And you can see the championship experience of Blake Dennis and Brian Aragon really giving them the advantage here in the final round.
Jeff Stockwell, what a great finish. There he is, your world champion, 2 years running. Brian Aragon had such an incredible season. Unfortunately, it came down to one trick, and he missed it. Good enough for second. But Blake Dennis, two times the charm.
Blake Dennis, a lot of contests this season, we've seen you come really close. It's like you've had the perfect lines, you had everything going, and there would always be one trick where it just sort of fell apart. What a perfect time to put it all together.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy. I haven't landed a run all year, so what can I say? Yeah, stoked to land it.
How much pressure was there to come out here and defend your world championship?
I didn't really think about that, like the world championship thing, but like at first I was just nervous to get into the finals, but then when I was in 10th, I guess I had nothing to lose, and I like moved up a bit for the second run, and then my final run, I just landed everything. Happy about that, yeah.
Truly one of the elite skaters of all time, no doubt about that. We knew it even before the contest. A great contest, wide open, but true champion skates away with it, defending his title, Blake Dennis, from the World Championships here at the ASA.
Blake Dennis finishes the year ranked 6th overall, but the battle between Brian Aragon and Stefan Alfano, Brian Aragon comes out on top, the 2003 number one ranked rider on street. Now time for the LG pick trick. So many amazing tricks, but Blake Dennis has to get the nod. Check it out. Backside fast slide all the way up and around, over and over and over. So much consistency.
Special thanks to Clear Channel Radio, Musco Lighting, the official lighting supplier of the ASA, WMI Medical Services, performing athlete and consumer medical services at events worldwide. On behalf of Mark Shays and Davey Blair, I am Arlo Eisenberg. Thank you for joining us this season on the ASA Pro Tour. Look for all of the LG Action Sports Championships and log on to lgactionsports.com.